Hello students, welcome back, and we are continuing with the chapter the fundamental unit of life. The fundamental unit of life mein cell wala, basic parts of the cell wala, sare parts humare cover up ho chuke the. Now today we are going to start with the cellular organelles. Cellular organelles मैंने आपको शुरू से ही पढ़ाया है कि किसी भी वर्ड को, किसी भी टर्म को हम लेते हैं तो वी शुड टेक दैट टर्म इन टू पार्ट्स. ठीक है, सेलुलर ऑर्गेनेल्स में एक तो सेलुलर है जिसका मतलब है सेल. द नेक्स्ट वर्ड इज ऑर्गेनेल्स. व्हाट आर बेसिकली ऑर्गेनेल्स? ऑर्गेनेल्स आर स्मॉल ऑर्गन्स of the cell. Organelles word is basically useful small organs, yeah, we can say small parts. These cellular organelles are also known as membrane bound organelles. Because all the organelles are bound with the membrane, and the membrane of the organelles are same as the cell membrane. Jaisa cell membrane ka composition hai, jaisa structure hai, वैसे ही in membrane bound organelles ka structure hai. Now these cellular organelles are absent in prokaryotic cells. अगर प्रॉपर डेफिनेशन लिखनी हो हमें सेलुलर ऑर्गेनेल्स की तो उसकी क्या डेफिनेशन होगी? द डेफिनेशन वुड बी द स्मॉल ऑर्गन लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स दैट in various chemical activities. Of the cell. As we know that multicellular organisms, multicellular eukaryotic organisms are having complex body. ठीक है, तो उनकी body को basically support करने के लिए या फिर organization में रखने के लिए बहुत सारे different काम होते हैं, and ये different chemical activities उनकी ज़रूरत जो होती है ये कैसे complete करता है? एक cell अपने different organs में क्या कर लेता है? Labor division. Importance of cellular organelles में हम लिखेंगे point of labor division. Importance of cellular organelles. It helps in performing various activities of the cell. It helps in performing various activities of the cell. Form complex cellular structures. Complex cellular structures that help to support the body complex body, basically the complex body of multicellular organisms. Okay, so that is all about. It is so easy, so basic and so interesting also. सेल ऑर्गेनाइज करती हैं लेबर डिवीजन का काम. जब अब देखो लेबर डिवीजन की एग्जांपल देती हूँ. व्हाट इज लेबर डिवीजन? बेसिकली हम ह्यूमन बीइंग्स हैं, हमारी मल्टी सेलुलर बॉडी है, तो हमें क्या चाहिए? हमें प्रोटीन्स भी चाहिए. अगर हमें प्रोटीन्स चाहिए तो हमें प्रोटीन फॉर्म करने का एक स्ट्रक्चर चाहिए. देन उस स्ट्रक्चर को जब सपोज करो मुझे अभी इसी वक्त एक प्रोटीन की ज़रूरत है, तो क्या अभी इसी वक्त प्रोटीन फॉर्म हो जाएगा इतनी जल्दी और इतनी जल्दी मैं यूज़ कर पाऊँगी? नो. प्रोटीन फॉर्मेशन वाले एक ऑर्गन की ज़रूरत है, उसके बाद मुझे एक स्टोरिंग ऑर्गन की ज़रूरत है जो स्टोर करके रख सके, उसके बाद एक डिस्पैचिंग ऑर्गन की भी ज़रूरत है जिस पार्ट ऑफ द सेल को या जहाँ पे बॉडी में चाहिए. सेल बेसिकली वो क्या करेगा? डिस्पैच करेगा. जिस पार्ट ऑफ द सेल को प्रोटीन्स चाहिए या कोई भी मटेरियल चाहिए तो वो वहाँ तक सेंड कर सके, डिस्पैच कर सके. एंड देन एनर्जी बनाने के लिए भी, क्योंकि एनर्जी की हमें बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरत होती है. हर सेल को, हर टिश्यू को एनर्जी की ज़रूरत होती है, तो उसके लिए भी हमें एक अलग ऑर्गन चाहिए. बेसिकली दिस इज नोन एज द लेबर डिवीजन. एंड ऐसे करके हमारे जो सेलुलर ऑर्गेनेल्स हैं वो लेबर डिवीजन का काम करते हैं. वेरियस सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स दैट आर इंक्लूडेड इन अ यूकैरियोटिक सेल, दीज आर गॉल्जी अपरेटस, एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम एंड माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया. गॉल्जी अपरेटस, एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम देन द माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया देन द लाइसोसोम्स देन द प्लास्टिड्स एंड देन द वैक्यूल्स. दीज आर सर्टेन सेलुलर ऑर्गेनेल्स दैट आर प्रेजेंट इन अ यूकैरियोटिक सेल. एंड ऐसे ऐसे करके दे परफॉर्म, ऑल द सेलुलर ऑर्गेनेल्स परफॉर्म क्रूशियल फंक्शंस. All the cellular organelles perform crucial functions that are important for survival of an organism. That are important for the survival of an organism. So, first of all, let us start with the Golgi apparatus. We are going to start in the other part of the board. So, let us first start with the Golgi apparatus. The name of the scientist is Camillo Golgi. What is the name of the scientist? That is Camillo Golgi. तो ये जो गॉल्जी अपरेटस है, इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज डिस्कवर्ड और नेम्ड दीज मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड वेसिकल्स are known as Golgi apparatus. It is also known as the Golgi bodies. We can call them as Golgi bodies. Golgi complex, and it is named behind the name of the scientist who discovered it, Camillo Golgi. So, what is the definition of Golgi apparatus? These are membrane bound vesicles that are enclosed in a membrane. Okay, basically isko Golgi apparatus kehte hain. These vesicles are the flat end sacs. Abhi dekho. These are Golgi bodies. Golgi bodies may be, let me rub this. I hope you got this, the topic of cell organelles, hai na? So, abhi hum start karte hain. Next topic, that is the thing is that these vesicles, kaun se wale vesicles, ye wale vesicles, the continuation of this thing I am doing here. These vesicles may be arranged in stacks and are called cisterns. These are the Golgi bodies. Okay. This whole thing is the Golgi complex. These are forming the stack-like structures. Stack-like structures ki ek ke upar ek vesicle chad raha hai. To isko hum kya bolte hain? Cisternae. What cisternae is basically ki ye jo vesicles hain, flattened sacs, may be arranged in the form of stacks and are known as cisterns. In some cases, basically hum functions ki baat karte hain pehle. What are the functions of Golgi complex? They help in packaging and dispatching of packaging and dispatching of the proteins that are formed in. I'm sorry, the marker is not working. Let me change it. That are formed in the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay. This was all about. The next function is, it also helps in storage and thus it also helps in storage and thus in animals it may be called as a storehouse of the cell, but you do not need to confuse yourself in it, because generally jo storehouse of the cells hai wo vacuoles ko hi bola jata hai, storing vacuoles ko, food vacuoles ko storehouse of the cell bola jata hai, because wo kya karke rakhte hain, wo saman ko store karke rakhte hain whenever there is a need. But as we know ki plants ke andar jo vacuole hota hai, that is not very big, because plants don't need it. Oh, animals don't need it. Theek hai, to animals ke storehouse of the cell ko, in some cases we can say that Golgi complex is the storehouse of the cell, but you don't need to read it. What does it do now? It converts the simple sugars to the complex sugars. It converts the simple sugar to the complex sugars. It converts the simple sugars to complex sugar, and at last in some cases it helps in formation of lysosomes. It helps in manufacturing of lysosomes. So that is all about. That is all about the Golgi complex, the functions of the Golgi complex, and the composition, the structure of the Golgi complex. Now, at last, let me tell you one more thing, and that is, I would write it here. In some cases, the Golgi complex is attached with the endoplasmic reticulum. In some cases, the Golgi complex may be found attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. And thus, in this way, it forms a complex cellular structure. And in this way, it forms the complex cellular structure. Now, let us talk about the endoplasmic reticulum. rub it with the help of this. Ink is really dark. The black ink is really dark, and it is really difficult to rub up. That was all because of you students, so that you students are able to see my handwriting properly. That's why we use the dark ink. Okay, well, let us now start with endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so our next cell organelle is endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum, also known as ER. It is of two types. Types ki baat karne se pehle, let us read about its structure. The ER, or the endoplasmic reticulum, is a network of tubes and sheets forming endoplasmic reticulum is a network of tubes and sheets forming a channel like structure. अब हमें जब पता चल ही गया एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम कैसा दिखता है, लेट अस ड्रॉ दिस एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम. ऐसे भी ड्रॉ करके देख सकते हो इसको, यू कैन ऑल्सो ड्रॉ इट इन दिस वे. So basically endoplasmic reticulum is a network, ये एक network form कर रहा है of tubes and sheets, sheets and tubes, and it forms a channel like structure. Now basically what is the function of this endoplasmic reticulum? फंक्शन को देखने के लिए आई टोल्ड यू दैट ईआर इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स. तो पहले हमें इसके टाइप्स के बारे में पता करना पड़ेगा. ओके, सो दिस इज आर ई आर. आर ई आर, आर मीन्स रफ, ER means endoplasmic reticulum. RER and SER. SER means smooth endoplasmic reticulum. There are two types of endoplasmic reticulum, the rough endoplasmic reticulum and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Why the rough endoplasmic reticulum is known as the rough endoplasmic reticulum, and why the smooth endoplasmic reticulum is known as the smooth endoplasmic reticulum? Let me draw the structure of both. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is known as rough endoplasmic reticulum because it has ribosomes attached to the surface of its tubes. And under the electron microscope, first of all, let me tell you that the mostly the organelles are mostly the cellular organelles are visible under electron microscope. Mostly the cellular organelles are visible under the electron microscope. These organelles, ये जो rough endoplasmic reticulum है, इसको rough endoplasmic reticulum क्यों बोला जाता है? Because under the electron microscope, under the electron microscope, electron microscope, the surface of ER looks rough. That's why it is known as rough endoplasmic reticulum. And why? Because RER has ribosomes attached to its surface. So that is the definition of rough endoplasmic reticulum. That why the rough endoplasmic reticulum is known as rough endoplasmic reticulum, or this is the answer to why RER is named so, or what is, or what is RER. ठीक है, इन दोनों क्वेश्चंस का आंसर है, दिस इज दैट अंडर द इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप द सर्फेस ऑफ द ईआर लुक्स रफ, बिकॉज रफ एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम हैज राइबोसोम्स अटैच्ड टू इट, टू इट्स सर्फेस. ऑन द अदर हैंड, इफ आई विजुलाइज द स्मूथ एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम, it has no, at all, no ribosomes attached to its surface. Thus, the surface of smooth endoplasmic reticulum looks smooth. Okay? Now, let me write you here that why smooth endoplasmic reticulum is named so. Why SER is named so? Because under the microscope, the surface of the SER looks smooth as it has no ribosomes attached to its surface. That's why rough endoplasmic reticulum or smooth endoplasmic reticulum is known as smooth endoplasmic reticulum, because of the appearance of the smooth surface. Okay students, so that was all about the endoplasmic reticulum for today's topic. Kal ko hum karne wale hain the difference between the smooth endoplasmic reticulum and the rough endoplasmic reticulum, and ribosomes ke attach hone se ya na attach hone se inke functions pe, inke structure pe to yahi fark padta hai ki rough dikhti hai surface and smooth dikhti hai surface, but inke functions pe kya asar padta hai wo hum kal ko karne wale hain. Now you have to remember कि endoplasmic reticulum is a membrane bound organelle, है ना? Membrane bound मतलब जो इसकी membrane है, that is equal to the structure, the composition of the cell membrane only. And membrane bound organelles, ये cellular organelles को membrane bound organelles क्यों बोला जाता है? बिकॉज इनकी जो रिजेम्बलेंस होती है, स्ट्रक्चर एंड कॉम्पोजिशन रिजेम्बलेंस होती है, उनके पास भी एक अपनी मेम्ब्रेन होती है, जिसकी वजह से इनको मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड ऑर्गेनेलीज बोला जाता है. और जो इनकी मेम्ब्रेन होती है उनका जो स्ट्रक्चर है दैट रिजेम्बल्स द सेल मेम्ब्रेन ओनली. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो दैट वॉज ऑल फॉर टुडे. थैंक्स अ लॉट. थैंक यू.